Today on Zoom, we want to see if we can support my weight in something other than cups. Balloons.
You want me to pop one?
Yeah, pop one.
Come on.
Meet Bugsy. Isn't he cute? He's almost too cute to eat. Not cute enough.
The world is never nubby, power pub another. The sky of his never pub 11.
Funding for Zoom is provided by
the National Science Foundation,
America's investment in the future,
and by
the Corporation for Public Broadcasting,
a private corporation funded by the American people,
the Arthur Vining Davis Foundation,
the Wheezy Foundation,
the Tucker Gosnell Family Foundation,
and by
contributions to your PBS station
from viewers like you.
Hi, we're Swift River Elementary, right here in Belchertown, Massachusetts.
Get ready to Zoom! Yay!
Alright!
Woohoo! Play ball!
Play ball, better, better.
You can do it!
Let's go! Woo-hoo. Come on, you got it!
Come on.
Alright.
Come on, King!
Come on, Zoomer. Let's hit that ball.
I'm Eduardo.
I'm Garrett.
I'm Mike.
I'm Courtney.
Oh, yeah.
And I'm singing.
We're all plugged into one room now.
So let's talk.
We want to hear from you.
Come on, give it a try.
And if you like what you see, turn off your TV and do it.
WGBY.
Remember when we played the ball on spoon race where you balance a tennis ball on a spoon? And remember when we played the three-legged race where two people tie their legs together to make three legs? Well, Callie T. of Farmersville, Ohio emailed us this great idea. Combine the two for the three-legged ball on spoon race.
So to play, you'll need a bandana, two spoons, and two tennis balls for each team. Now, you have to pair up into teams of two and tie your legs together. You have to put your tennis balls on your spoon and balance them. Then, you have to walk around the cone and back to the starting line. If you drop your ball, you have to stop, put it back on the spoon, and then keep on going. The first team back wins. Okay, so here are your tennis balls and your spoons. Right. All right, you guys, on your mark. On your mark, get set. Having a little trouble here. Okay, on your mark, get set, go.
And
looks like Caroline and Alina. Oh, Alina dropped her ball. Garrett and Mike are right now in the lead. Caroline and Alina are second, and Courtney and Shannon are third. Oh, Courtney's ball fell all the way over there. Rolling.
Right. Outside. Outside. Inside. Outside.
Looks like I'm good
out,
technique.
Out.
Okay. Caroline and Alini. Alright, Caroline and Alini, Courtney and Shimmy. They're tied right now.
Inside.
Garrett and Mike are first place. And they just fell down.
Out.
Courtney and Shimmy.
Like
both teams.
We're in. We're in second. We're in second. We're in second.
like your personality?
I like the color yellow because it reminds me of the sun and it reminds me of the summer when it's hot.
The color that suits my personality best is white because the clouds are white and I like to stare at the clouds.
Green because I like to climb trees.
I like brown. Brown because I have a bunny and she's brown.
The color that suits my personality the best is orange because I like oranges and they're orange.
Blue because it is part of the American flag.
My favorite color is green because I like tree leaves.
Blue because my house color is blue.
The color that best fits my personality is red because I love apples.
Silver because that's the color of my football team's jersey.
Meet Bugsy. Joey S. of Hingham, Massachusetts sent us directions on how to make him. This is Bugsy. Isn't he cute? Okay. This is what you're going to need to make your own Bugsy. First, take a pretzel stick and place some Fruity O's on the pretzel stick. You need to choose the O's with the bigger holes so that they fit around the stick. Okay, this one looks good. Once you have all of your Fruity cereal O's on the pretzel stick, put that aside. Next, take two pretzel sticks and place some Fruity cereal O's on the ends of each stick. Not sure if this one's gonna fit. It's a little small. But that's good. Now put those aside. Now, take two pretzel sticks and break them in half. These will be Bugsy's legs. Now, take the peeled banana and put on two raisins for eyes on the end of the banana. Those are Bugsy's eyes. Now, take the tail you made for Bugsy and put it on the opposite side of the eyes in the end of the peeled banana. That's his tail. Now, take the pretzel sticks you put the Fruity O's on the end of and put them behind the eyes. This will be Bugsy's antennae. And finally, put the pretzel sticks, put the legs that you made for Bugsy by breaking pretzel sticks in half in the bottom of the banana. These are Bugsy's legs. And there you have it, your very own Bugsy. He's almost too cute to eat, but not cute enough. Not bad.
Hey, Stuarto.
Hi, Garrett.
What did the cook name his son?
I don't know.
Stew. Did you get it? Stew?
I really do most of my designs on the computer, but sometimes I start off by sketching them. My name is Marwan, and I'm 9 years old.
Marwan, computer خلصت ولا عاوز تعمله؟
مش يا بابا نجاي. My mom and dad come from Egypt, so I speak Arabic at home. My dad's an architect. I learned to use a 3D program. I could do really cool things with it. This is a design I was working on, and this design is about two buildings. I was thinking of putting a walkway through it. Like, so like a rectangle. Move it up. There's the walkway. This is a website where you can look at some ideas that people have had for rebuilding the World Trade Center. When I saw this website, I got really, really interested in making my own designs of the World Trade Center. First, I was thinking of making a memorial for the people who died in the World Trade Center. One of my ideas is to make a base of a cone and a column, then the American flag. Then I'll put a spiral staircase, then a cone, You can use it for almost something like an observation tower. There's another idea for the World Trade Center with an office building. First, I put a hexagon base. After that, I put a door. Then I put a tall office building on top of the hexagon base. Then I thought it wouldn't be enough workspace for the World Trade Center. So I thought of making, instead of just one building, 7 buildings. What I've done so far is a memorial, then an office building. So I was thinking of adding a memorial and an office building together. I put 2 tall towers. Then I put a circular walkway around the 2 buildings so people could walk or sit and think if they wanted. I don't know what they're going to build for the replacement of the World Trade Center, but whatever they're going to build, I really want to go see it.
Jackie E. of Atlanta, Georgia, sent the Fleas Fanny Doo.
Fanny Dooley likes Swiss, cheddar, and mozzarella cheese, but doesn't like Munster, Gouda, or Monterey Jack.
Why do you think that is?
Fanny Dooley likes vacuuming, but doesn't like chores.
Why do you think that is?
Likes things that are ripped, but doesn't like things that are torn.
Why do you think that is?
Oh, yeah!
All right! What's up with Fanny Dooley? If you know, send it to Zoom.
Fanny Dooley!
Right.
Hey, Caroline.
Oh, hey, Garrett.
What did the chef say after he dropped his waffles?
I don't know.
How waffle!
Get it, get it? How awful.
Do you remember when we tested out cups and found that one large paper coffee cup was able to support my weight? Well, now, we want to see if we can support my weight with something other than cups. Balloons.
Do you want to take the balloons down so they don't move?
Yeah, sure.
Okay.
Thank you. So here.
Yeah.
Balloon.
What do you think will happen?
I don't know.
I think it might pop.
I know. I think it might pop.
I think it'll work with 10, but maybe pop when it gets to like 9.
Yeah, 9 or 8.
Okay. Do you have a pen?
Yeah.
Thank you.
The cardboard is down.
Okay. All right, ready?
Ready.
Okay.
Whoa.
Oh, it's really slippery. All right. What's it feel like? Is it going down at all?
It feels in the middle. It's going down a little bit, not on the side.
It feels
sturdy.
The balloons are like bending. Will you feel comfortable if I pop one?
Yeah.
Okay, ready?
Yeah.
Okay, so that's 9. Do you feel any different?
Only on this side.
They're getting really low and they're just squishing out, kind of.
So I'll pop another one.
All right. So now that there's 8 left, did you feel a difference in that?
Yeah, I felt, because my foot was right here and it just went down.
Yeah, you're going a lot lower too.
Oh, yeah.
The balloons are changing shape.
Okay, ready?
Okay, pop.
Okay, now I felt that one.
Okay.
I felt the sound of my leg
lower that time. So there's 7 left.
Okay, I felt that one too.
Why don't you pop one in the back?
Okay.
So how many do we have left?
There's 6 left. Oh, I felt that one.
Right,
on the back.
Look at how much the balloons are stretching. They totally
I know.
So be careful. Hold on to them really tight.
I felt that one.
Okay, you're going down really low.
How many balloons are this?
I think there's 3 left. Let me swing this. There's
4.
4?
Oh, okay.
You ready?
Okay.
Now there's 3.
Now there's 3, and
they're stretching down really low.
Yeah. They're changing shape.
Yeah. So why don't you cut one in the front?
Now I'm trying to balance myself on these 2 balloons.
So they're really flat.
Here, what do you pop?
2nd to last.
Oh. Okay, that's the one. Hold on.
Yeah! It was for like a second.
I know, it was up there, and then once I got all my weight on it just
it totally was like,
boom, boom.
I know,
it's so cool.
I guess it just couldn't take all the pressure.
Yeah.
You guys want to take them all off and then try water balloons?
Oh, that'd be fun. So cool.
Oh. 9.
Oh, can I get the last one?
Yeah.
Cool.
10.
Oh my gosh.
And
this is gonna be so much
pen.
Fun. So, oh, it'll be awesome when we pop them.
Okay. I need a
new pin. I don't know if it's gonna hold you.
I think maybe you'll feel sturdier.
I don't know. Maybe since, you know how air was taking up the space?
Now it's water.
Okay, so let's try.
Whoa, we have to find out, don't we?
Yeah.
Okay, ready?
This is so exciting.
Let's just do it.
Oh. All right, ready?
Oh. Okay.
The big moment.
Oh, it holds it.
It holds it.
Yeah, they're definitely squished. Do you want me to pop one?
Yeah, pop one.
Come on, can we?
Yeah.
Down a lot.
How many do you think we're going to get before?
I think we're going to get to like seven.
Oh,
oh, oh,
oh, oh, oh, oh, wow, it went down a lot.
Ready?
And that went down a lot in the front, so why don't we pop one in the back?
Yeah, okay. Pop one in the back. Wait, let's just see. Does it feel like squishy?
Yeah, it feels really weird. Like, it's wiggling about and It's going down
and
as much as
in the middle. So how many do we have left?
I think we have six.
Okay, cool.
So six.
Do you want me to pop one?
Yeah. Oh. each time you pop,
it goes down
even more.
Whoa, they're really squished.
Okay, I'm gonna pop one.
Oh. Are you still going? That's five.
Oh man, that one was like.
Oh, you're going down on outside.
No, I'm
going to
try to
balance him. Okay. Chingy,
keep holding on to him.
Okay.
So, how many are left, guys?
I think there's three left.
Wow, they're really smushed. Their shape has changed completely.
Oh, that one.
Hold on. I'll try to stand on it. Don't move.
Okay, let's see the bottom. I'm going to try.
Oh, pop one. Hold on. Pop that one in the back.
Oh, I can see it coming out of the back.
Look it.
Hold on. Hey, are you still going?
Yeah, I'm on this. I'm on the moon.
We got one.
It's like surfing.
Is that one?
Yeah.
Wait. There's one.
Oh, that's so cool.
It's holding me up.
Oh, my gosh.
Oh, my gosh.
You're wicked love.
I can't believe we went down from 10 water balloons.
This one worked better than the air did.
Yeah.
Like, it gradually...
Because I think it can, like,
it has
farther.
More space to
I
know.
Stretch it.
See how fat it gets when it stretches?
And it just goes, like, out.
I know.
That's
so cool.
We were able to get one paper cup to support Derek's weight. This is because paper is very strong when you pull on it a certain way. See how strong it is when I tug on it like this? This is called tension. We are also able to support all of Garrett's weight on one water balloon. This is because balloons are also strong. If you pull on a balloon like this, it stretches. But if you pull on a piece of paper, it doesn't stretch.
But since the balloons changed shape when I stood on them, they weren't able to hold me up as high as the cup did.
Would your results be the same if you filled the balloon with something else, like helium or salty water? Why don't you try it out and send your results to Zoom?
Hey, lady.
Hey, Garrett.
Why did the baker stop making donuts?
I have no idea.
Because he was tired of the whole business.
I'm part of the Zoom team.
My grandfather and I visit the dog pound. We have been coming here together for many years. The dogs and puppies here are strays, which means they're homeless, and so we like to cheer them up. One day, when I was visiting, I met Buddy. My family has two dogs already, but there was something special about Buddy. I guess my grandfather Poppy thought so too, because he took Buddy home, but I take care of him. He has a leash, a collar, and I walk him and feed him. I also make sure he stays clean.
Do you volunteer in your community? If you do, you're already a member of the Zoom team. We want to hear all about it. Send your story, along with any photos or videos, to this address.
Remember, the little things you do can sometimes make a big difference.
Zoom into action.
And join the Zoom team.
You might remember
remember when we made rainbow cake on Cafe Zoom.
See? This is what it looks like on the inside. It's colorful. It's a rainbow.
Well, Marina M. of Gresham, Oregon, sent us this letter along with some pictures. Dear Zoomers, I am writing to thank you for showing how to make the delicious, creative, and beautiful rainbow cake. My mom and I made it for my 7th birthday. It was so much fun making it, and all my friends loved it. Here are some pictures for you so that you can see how nicely it turned out and how happy all my friends were. Thanks, Marina. If you want the recipe to make your own rainbow cake, then you can go to the Cafe Zoom section of the Zoom website at pbskids.org.
Welcome to Ubby Dubby Fairy Tales. Once upon a time, there was a little chicken whose name was Chicken Little. One day, Chicken Little was walking through the woods. As she passed by the oak tree, an acorn fell on her head. She got really scared. After all, she was a chicken.
My mama stole the towel of a coven.
So she ran to tell the king. Along the way, she met Henny Penny. Along the way, they met Ducky Lucky. So they all ran down the road as fast as they could. Soon, they met Goosey Lucy walking by the pond.
Wubba rubba yubba gubba wubbin subbo fubbass.
Wubba rubba nummy subby subby nubba cubbing.
Subba scubba yubba nubba loving.
Wubba.
Hubba dubba yubba nubba dubba scubba yubba subba loving.
Zubby subba rubba wubba subba rubba and abba.
Yubbies, lubu, wubbies. Lubbin, abbi, bubba, rubber, rubbin, wubbif, yubbu.
So they ran as fast as they could until they met Foxy Loxy.
Hubba, gubbas, wubba, rubber, yubbu, wubbu, gubbu, wubbing. Wubble, wubble. Abba dubba yabba nubble zubba scubba yabba's fubble rubbing.
Shubby subba abba wubba tubba rubba on abbeyes.
Abba hubba dubba wubba tubba rubba on abbeyes.
Abba pubba dubba wubba tubba rubba on hubbed.
Rubba thrubba.
Wubba fubble rubba on hubber hubbed. Hubbled abba on. Lubba's jubba's gubbled abba'n subba'd abba'n cubba'm dubba.
So Foxy Loxy brought them all to his den to try to figure out what was going on.
Lubba subba cubba chubba mubby. Cubba lubbin. Lubba's jubba's chubba lubba wubba thubber abba'n tubby rubby.
Lubbis, abbis, tabba tubbin, lubba tubbin, lub pobba tubbin, lubba, frubbum, zubby, ubba chubby. Tibu dubba, zubba, wubba dubba, rubba mubba, dubba dubba, scubba, wubba, fubba lubba. Lubbis, abbis, nubba, chubby. Dubba, rubbis, nubba, nubby, proba, pubba, nubba. Dubba, scubba, abbis, nubba, fubba lubba. Rubber puppies. Rubber stubby, rubber nubba, rubber rubber. Rubber stubbies, color tubby, mother tubby. Rubber 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 shovel. Rubber kibber.
Double syllable lubby. Double zubar. Obey cub orange.
Obey cub orange.
Obey cub orange.
Obey cub orange.
Chubby cub and lubby tumble.
Zubble.
After they found out the real story, they went out and gathered acorns for a yummy dinner of acorn soup, acorn muffins, with acorn pie for dessert.
And Chicken Little was never hit with falling sky again.
Never mind.
Hey, you got to make it known. You got to send us
you want to make a difference in your community, but need some help getting started? Well, you can find lots of tips and information on volunteering at the Zoom Into Action section of the Zoom website at pbskids.org or America Online, keyword PBS Kids.
Become the property of Zoom
and will be eligible for inclusion in all Zoom media.
This means that we can share your ideas
with other Zoomers on TV, the web, in print material,
and in other media. So, send it to Zoom.
Zoom? Put the legs that you made for Bugsy in the bottom of the banana. Now I gotta adjust this. He's not really standing up for me right now. Okay, Bugsy's gonna take a nap right now. Okay, good night, Bugsy. So that Bugsy stands up. Just like that.
Funding for Zoom is provided by
the National Science Foundation,
America's investment in the future,
and by
the Corporation for Public Broadcasting,
a private corporation funded by the American people.
The Arthur Vine and Davis Foundation.
The Wheezy Foundation.
The Tubbs and Gosno Family Foundation.
And by contributions to your PBS station
from viewers like you.
Like your personality?
I like the color yellow because it reminds me of the sun and it reminds me of the summer when it's hot.
The color that suits my personality best is white because the clouds are white and I like to stare at the clouds.
Green because I like to climb trees.
I like brown because I have a bunny and she's brown.
The color that suits my personality the best is orange because I like oranges and they're orange.
Blue because it is part of the American flag.
My favorite color is green because I like tree leaves.
Blue because my house color is blue.
The color that best fits my personality is red because I love apples.
Silver because that's the color of my football team's jersey.
Bugsy. Joey S. of Hingham, Massachusetts sent us directions on how to make him. This is Bugsy. Isn't he cute?
Okay. This is what you're going to need to make your own Bugsy. First, take a pretzel stick and place some Fruity O's on the pretzel stick. You need to choose the O's with the bigger holes so that they fit around the stick. Okay, this one looks good. Once you have all of your Fruity Cereal O's on the pretzel stick, put that aside. Next, take two pretzel sticks and place some Fruity Cereal O's on the ends of each stick. Not sure if this one's gonna fit. It's a little small. But that's good. Now put those aside. Now, take two pretzel sticks and break them in half. These will be Bugsy's legs. Now, take the peeled banana and put on two raisins for eyes on the end of the banana. Those are Bugsy's eyes. Now, take the tail you made for Bugsy and put it on the opposite side of the eyes in the end of the peeled banana. That's his tail. Now, take the pretzel sticks you put the Fruity O's on the end of and put them behind the eyes. This will be Bugsy's antennae. And finally, put the pretzel sticks, put the legs that you made for Bugsy by breaking pretzel sticks in half in the bottom of the banana. These are Bugsy's legs. And there you have it, your very own Bugsy. He's almost too cute to eat, but not cute enough. Not bad.
Hey, Stuarto.
Hi, Garrett.
What did the cook name his son?
I don't know.
Stew. You get it? Stew?
I really do most of my designs on the computer, but sometimes I start off by sketching them. My name is Marwan, and I'm 9 years old.
Marwan, the computer خلصت ولا عاوز تعمله؟
مش بابا نجاي. My mom and dad come from Egypt, so I speak Arabic at home. My dad's an architect. I learned to use a 3D program. I can do really cool things with it. This is a design I was working on, and this design is about two buildings. I was thinking of putting a walkway through it. Like a solid rectangle. Move it up. There's the walkway. This is a website where you can look at some ideas that people have had for rebuilding the World Trade Center. When I saw this website, I got really, really interested in making my own designs of the World Trade Center. First, I was thinking of making a memorial for the people who died in the World Trade Center. One of my ideas is to make a base of a cone and a column, then the American flag. Then I'll put a spiral staircase, then a cone. You can use it for almost something like an observation tower. There's another idea for the World Trade Center with an office building. First, I put a hexagon base. After that, I put a door. Then I put a tall office building on top of the hexagon base. Then I thought it wouldn't be enough workspace for the World Trade Center. So I thought of making, instead of just one building, seven buildings. What I've done so far is a memorial, then an office building. So I was thinking of adding a memorial and an office building together. I put two tall towers. Then I put a circular walkway around the two buildings so people could walk or sit and think if they wanted. I don't know what they're going to build for the replacement of the World Trade Center, but whatever they're going to build, I really want to go see it.
Jack,
WATE of Atlanta, Georgia sent to feed Fanny Dewey.
Fanny Dewey likes Swiss, cheddar, and mozzarella cheese, but doesn't like Munster, Gouda, or Monterey Jack.
Why do you think that is?
Fanny Dewey likes vacuuming, but doesn't like chores.
Why do you think that is?
Fanny Dewey likes things that are ripped, but doesn't like things that are torn.
Why do you think that is? Oh, yeah!
All right! What's up with Fanny Dewey? If you know, send it to Zoom.
Fanny Dewey!
All right!
Hey, Caroline.
Oh, hey, Eric.
What did the chef say after he dropped his waffles?
I don't know.
How waffle!
Get it, get it?
Do you remember when we tested out cups and found that one large paper coffee cup was able to support my weight? Well, now, we want to see if we can support my weight with something other than cups. Balloons.
Do you want to take the balloon down so they don't move?
Yeah, sure.
Stick.
Thank you. So here.
Yeah.
Balloon.
What do you think will happen?
I don't know.
I think it might pop.
I know, I think it might pop.
I think it'll work with 10, but maybe pop when it gets to like 9.
Yeah, 9 or 8.
Okay. Do you have a pen?
Yeah.
Thank you.
The cardboard is down.
Okay. All right, ready?
Ready. Okay. Whoa. Oh, it's really slippery.
All right. What's it feel like? Is it going down at all?
It feels, in the middle, it's going down a little bit, not on the sides. It feels sturdy.
The balloons are like bending. Will you feel comfortable if I pop one?
Yeah.
Okay, ready?
Yeah.
Okay, so that's 9. Do you feel any different?
Only on this side.
They're getting really low and they're just squishing out, kind of.
So I'll pop another one.
All right. So now there's eight left. Did you feel a difference in that?
Yeah, I felt, because my foot was right here and it just went down.
Yeah, you're going a lot lower too.
Oh, yeah.
The balloons are changing shape.
Okay, ready?
Okay, pop.
Okay, now I felt that one.
Okay.
I felt it down a lot lower that time.
So there's 7 left.
Okay, I felt that one too.
Why don't you pop one in the back?
Okay.
So how many do we have left?
There's 6 left. Oh, I felt that one.
Right,
really on the back.
Look at how much the balloons are stretching. They totally changed.
I know.
So be careful. Hold on to them really tight.
I felt that one.
Okay, you're going down really low.
How many balloons are there?
I think there's 3 left.
Let me see.
There's 4.
4?
Oh, okay. You ready?
Okay.
Now there's 3.
Now there's three, and they're
stretching down really low.
Yeah. They're changing shape.
Yeah.
So
why don't you pop one in the front?
Now I'm trying to balance myself on these 2 balloons.
So what?
They're really flat.
What do you pop? Second to last.
Oh, okay. Hold on.
Yeah. It was for like a second.
It was up there, and then once I got all my weight on it,
it just totally was like.
Boom.
Boom.
So cool.
I guess it just couldn't take all the pressure.
Yeah.
You guys want to take them all off and then try water balloons?
Oh, that'd be so cool.
9.
Oh, can I get the last one?
Yeah.
Cool. All right, 10. Oh, my gosh. This is going to be so much
10.
Fun. It'll be awesome when we pop them.
Okay. I need a new pin. I don't know if it's going to hold you.
I think maybe you'll feel sturdier. I don't know. Maybe since, you know how air was taking up the space?
Now it's water.
Now it's water.
Okay, so let's try.
Whoa, we have to find out, don't we?
Yeah.
Okay, ready?
This is so exciting.
Let's just feel it.
Oh. All right, ready?
Oh.
Okay.
The big moment.
It holds it.
Yeah, they're
definitely squished.
Do you want me to pop one?
Yeah, pop one.
Pop one.
Okay.
Yeah.
Oh,
okay.
Wow, it went down a lot.
How many do you think we're going to get before?
I think we're going to get to like 8.
I think we're going to get to like 7.
7.
7?
Okay, go.
Let's
see to roll it. Wow, it went down a lot.
Ready?
Wow,
that went down a lot in the front, so
why don't
we pop one in the back?
Yeah, pop one in the back.
Wait,
let's just see. Does it feel like
stuff? Yeah, it feels really weird. Like, it's wiggling about, and it's going down.
And
It goes down even more.
Whoa, they're really squished.
Okay, I'm gonna pop one. Are you still going? That's five.
Oh man, that one was like...
You're going down on that side.
No, I'm gonna try to bounce it.
Okay. Chingin, keep holding on to him.
Okay.
So, how many are left, guys?
I think there's three left. Wow, they're really smushed. Their shape has changed completely.
Oh, that one. Hold on, I'll try to stand on it.
Don't move.
Okay, let's see the bottom. I'm going to try.
Oh, pop one. Hold on, pop that one in the back.
Oh, I can see it coming out of the back. Look it. Hold on. Hey, are you still going?
Yeah, I'm on this.
I'm on the moon.
We got one.
It's like surfing.
Is that one?
Yeah, wait.
Down from 10 water balloons.
This one worked better than the air did.
Yeah.
Like, it gradually...
Because I think it can, like,
step farther.
More space to
I know. See how fat it gets when it stretches?
And it just goes, like, out.
I know. That's so cool.
We were able to get one paper cup to support Derek's weight. This is because paper is very strong when you pull on it a certain way. See how strong it is when I tug on it like this? This is called tension. We are also able to support all of Garrett's weight on one water balloon. This is because balloons are also strong. If you pull on a balloon like this, it stretches. But if you pull on a piece of paper, it doesn't stretch.
But since the balloons changed shape when I stood on them, they weren't able to hold me up as high as the cup did.
Would your results be the same if you filled the balloon with something else, like helium or salty water? Why don't you try it out and send your results to Zoom?
You got to send us email.
email. Hey, Lainey.
Hey, Garrett.
Why did the baker stop making donuts?
I have no idea.
Because he was tired of the whole business.
Hi, I'm Phil and I'm part of the Zoom team.
My grandfather and I visit the dog pound. We have been coming here together for many years. The dogs and puppies here are strays, which means they're homeless, and so we like to cheer them up. One day, when I was visiting, I met Buddy. My family has two dogs already, but there was something special about Buddy. I guess my grandfather Poppy thought so too, because he took Buddy home, but I take care of him. He has a leash, a collar, and I walk him and feed him. I also make sure he stays clean.
Do you volunteer in your community? If you do, you're already a member of the Zoom team. We want to hear all about it. Send your story, along with any photos or videos, to this address.
Remember, the little things you do can sometimes make a big difference.
Zoom into action.
And join the Zoom team!
You might remember when we made rainbow cake on Cafe Zoom. See? This is what it looks like on the inside. It's colorful. It's a rainbow. Well, Marina M. of Gresham, Oregon, sent us this letter along with some pictures. Dear Zoomers, I'm writing to thank you for showing how to make the delicious, creative, and beautiful rainbow cake. My mom and I made it for my 7th birthday. It was so much fun making it, and all my friends loved it. Here are some pictures for you so that you can see how nicely it turned out and how happy all my friends were. Thanks, Marina. If you want the recipe to make your own rainbow cake, then you can go to the Cafe Zoom section of the Zoom website at pbskids.org.
Welcome to Ubby Dubby Fairy Tales. Once upon a time, there was a little chicken whose name was Chicken Little. One day, Chicken Little was walking through the woods. As she passed by the oak tree, an acorn fell on her head.
she got really scared. After all, she was a chicken.
Hello, the skull I always love loving, of my mama's skull which I will ever covet.
So she ran to tell the king. Along the way, she met Henny Penny. Along the way, they met Ducky Lucky. So they all ran down the road as fast as they could. Soon, they met Goosey Lucy walking by the pond.
Wubba rubba yubba gubba wubba subba fubbas.
Wubba rubba nummy subby subby nubba cubbing.
Wubba scubba yubba nubba loving.
Wubba.
Hubba rubba yubba nubba bubba scubba yubba bubba loving.
Yubby subba rubba wubba tubba rubba and abba.
Jubbies, lubu, lubbies, the nubby, bubba, rubba, rubbin, lubbif, yubbu.
So they ran as fast as they could until they met Foxy Loxy.
Hubba, gubbas, wubba, rubba, yubba, wubba, gubba, wubbing.
Dubba yabu nubble zubba scubba yabba's flubble rubbing.
Shubby subba abba wubba tubba rubba on ub eyes.
Amen hubba dubba wubba tubba rubba on ub ears.
Amen pubba dubba wubba tubba rubba tubba hubbed.
Rubbet rubba.
Wubbet bubba rubba on hubba hubbed. Hubbled ub on. Lubba's jubba's gubbled ebbin subbide ebbin cubbum zubbin.
So Foxy Loxy brought them all to his den to try to figure out what was going on.
Lubba subba cubba tubba mubby. Cubba mubbin. Lubba's jubba's chubba lubba wubba thubba ubba and tubby bubby.
Lubbis, abbis, tubba tubbin, lubba tubbin. Lubba pubba tubbin, lubba eye. Flubbum, zubby, elbow chubby. Tubba dubba, zubba, wubba dubba, rubba mubba. Dubba dubba, scubba eye, wubba subba lubba.
Today on Zoom,
we want to see if we can support my weight with something other than cups. Balloons.
You want me to pop one?
Yeah, pop one.
Pop one.
Meet Bugsy. Isn't he cute? He's almost too cute to eat. Not cute enough.
There was never another power pub another. There was never another pub another.
Today on Zoom,
we want to see if we can support my weight with something
other than cups. Funding for Zoom is provided by
the National Science Foundation,
America's investment in the future, and by the Corporation for Public Broadcasting,
a private corporation funded by the American people.
The Arthur Vine and Davis Foundation.
The Wheezy Foundation.
The Tucker Gosno Family Foundation.
And by contributions to your PBS station
from viewers like you.
Hi, we're Swift River Elementary, right here in Belchertown, Massachusetts.
Get ready to Zoom! Yeah!
Play ball!
Play ball, better, better.
You can do it!
Let's go!
Woo-hoo.
Come on, you got it!
Come on.
Woo-hoo. All right.
Come on, King!
Come on, Zoomer. Let's hit that ball.
I got it! I got it!
like what you see, turn off your TV and do it.
Zoom, zoom.
WGBY.
Remember when we played the ball on spoon race where you balance a tennis ball on a spoon? And remember when we played the three-legged race where two people tie their legs together to make three legs? Well, Callie T of Farmersville, Ohio emailed us this great idea. Combine the two for the three-legged ball on spoon race.
So to play, you'll need a bandana, two spoons, and two tennis balls for each team. Now, you have to pair up into teams of two and tie your legs together. You have to put your tennis balls on your spoon and balance them. Then, you have to walk around the cone and back to the starting line. If you drop your ball, you have to stop, put it back on the spoon, and then keep on going. The first team back wins. Okay, so here are your tennis balls and your spoons. Right. All right, you guys, on your mark... On your mark, get set. Having a little trouble here. Okay, on your mark, get set, go. It looks like Caroline and Alina. Oh, Alina dropped her ball. Garrett and Mike are right now in the lead. Caroline and Alina are second, and Courtney and Shannon are third. Oh, Courtney's ball fell all the way over there. Rolling.
Right. Outside. Inside. Outside.
Looks like I'm pretty good technique.
In. Out.
Caroline and Alina. Alright, Caroline and Alina, Courtney and Shinya. They're tied right now.